करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माण विधाति पूर्वं यो वेदागश्च प्रश्नोति तस्मै तगुम्हदेवमात्मोत्ति प्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमुखं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्रीचिद्भणगणेशाय नमो मह्यं सुखं नित्यं सप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूपयोः अधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्यं बुद्धेर्दुर्ग्यत्व निर्मलम् अपारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं महः तदेवाहन्नमत्तोऽन्यद् इति मे निश्चिता मतिः। So in the fourth taranga, Khyatiwada is being discussed. The four Khyatiwadas are refuted. And Anirvachaniya Khyati is being established. So when the Shishya asked, out of the four Khyatis, which is the best? The Guru said that all should be given up. All the other khyati should be given up and anirvachaniya khyati should be taken to, which is the siddhanta. And we saw in the end what happens exactly here. The samanakara vritti takes place on the rajju when the antakrana vritti goes out through the chakshurindriya. It forms a rajvakara vritti, but this is samanakara. Samanakara bhavati, but there is no rajju ajnana which is taken away because it is not in the rajju akara. Rajju has two amshas. One is the rajju amsha, which is the vishesh amsha, and samanya amsha is idam amsha. That idam amsha, which shows the astitvam, there is something there. The idam amsha is revealed by samanakara vritti. Then tataha na rajjo avarna bhanga jayate. So samanakara vritti is this. Tathapi sa tamadi doshai pratibaddha. Because the vritti is obstructed by the pramatrugata dosha, pramanagata dosha, aloka not being sufficient. Thereby pratibaddha vritti. Pratibaddha sati na rajju samanakara bhavati. It does not take the rajju akara, but it takes the idam akara there. ततः न रज्जोः आवरणभङ्गो जायते इत्थम् आवरणभञ्जक वृत्तिसंसर्गे सत्यपि यदा दोषैः रज्ज्वाम् आवरणभङ्गो न जायते तदा अधिष्ठानभूत रज्जोच्छिन्न चैतन्यनिष्ठ अविद्यायां कश्चन विक्षेपो जायते. देन् वाट् हेपन्स्, वी हव् सीन् देर् इस् अ विक्षेप. आवरणभङ्ग डस् नाट् टेक् प्लेस्. देन् दि सेकेण्ड् शक्ति आफ् अविद्या, विच् इस् विक्षेप शक्ति, इट् प्रोजेक्ट्स् समथिङ्ग् एल्स्, सर्प. तदा सा अविद्या सर्पाकारेण परिणमते. देन देयर इज अ सर्पाकार वृत्ति दैट टेक्स प्लेस. इट प्रोजेक्ट्स अ सर्प दैट इज अ विक्षेप ऑफ अविद्या. विच अविद्या? द अविद्या विच इज चैतन्य निष्ठ. अविद्या इज इन चैतन्य. विच चैतन्य? दैट चैतन्य, देयर ऑल्दो चैतन्य इज वन, दैट चैतन्य विच इज अवच्छिन्न, डिलिमिटेड बाय द रज्जु. रज्जवच्छिन्न चैतन्य which is in the form of adhisthana. Adhisthana bhuta rajyavachinna chaitanya nishtha vidyayam kashchana vikshepo jayate. It can be any kind of vikshepa. In the example where one sees sarpa there, sarpakarena parinamate avidya, savidya. Such a avidya karya bhuta sarpa. Now this sarpa is avidya karya, avidya vikshepa. Thereby sarpaha yadi sansyat. Had it really been there, now this is also countering the satkhyati vada. Although it is not done in the mula, still this itself can be used to counter the satkhyati which the tippanakara brought out. Sacha avidya karya bhuta sarpaha yadi sansyat. If it is real sansarpaha, then nasa rajju sakshat karana nivarteta. Anything that is real will never go by jnana. Rajju sakshatkara is knowing the adhisthana as adhisthana. If you know the rajju as rajju, then Sarpa, which is really created, cannot go away by knowing the Rajju, because it has already created a Sarpa. If it were so, Satkhyativada says that the atoms are the same, the components, avayavas, did not necessarily, we need not say atoms, any avayavas, the parts of the Rajju as well as the Sarpa. It looks much better in the Shuktika Rajata example, where you can talk about parts. Here there is a sentient thing. Sarpa is a sentient thing. Nonetheless, in Satkhyativada, there is something which is really born. And had Sarpa been really born, then Nasa Rajju Sakshat Karana Nivarteta. You cannot wish it away. There will be karma needed, and even karma cannot take away what is real. Real as in Paramarthika Satta. If it is Vyavaharika Satta, maybe the karma can counter it. But whether it is Paramarthika or Vyavaharika Sat, Vyavaharika Jnana will not take it away. Jnana cannot take it away. If it is real, actually Paramarthika, Vyavaharika, we do say Vyavaharika, it is not Vyavaharika Rajju. Like Rajju, it is not, Sarpa is not like Vyavaharika Rajju. You cannot have Vyavahara with Sarpa that you see. Only Vyavahara is in your mind, and thereby one runs away. However, you cannot, in a silver example, it is clear, you cannot use that silver for any transaction. It has no transactional value. So it is Pratibhasika. It does not have Vyavaharika Satta even. So Paramarthika Satta or Vyavaharika Satta cannot go away by Jnana. Sacha avidya karyabhuta sarpa yadi sansyat nasa rajju sakshat karana nivarteta nivrittischa anubhuyate. But nivritti is seen, so anyatha anubhupatya, it cannot be sat. Because it goes away from nivritti, it has nivrittis, there is sarpa nivritti, there is anubhava of sarpa nivritti, therefore sarpa cannot be real. Vikshepa is kalpita. Tasman naiva san saha sarpaha. Sarpa is not real. Atyanta asancha. Atyanta asat. In masculine it will become san. So asan. Atyanta asanchet syat saha sarpaha. Vandhya putra divat na upalabhyeta. And had it been completely non-existent, completely unreal, then would not be experienced, would not even be seen, cognized by anyone, like Vandhya Putradi, Gagana Pushpa Ityadi. Upalabhyate tu, but there is Sarpanubhava. Therefore, it is unlike Vandhya Putra, meaning it is not asat. Tasmat api asan sa sarpaha. Tasmat na api asan sa sarpa. That sarpa is not even asat. So it is not sat like anything, like Rajju. In the Rajju Sarpa example, Rajju and Sarpa have different levels of reality. It is unlike Rajju, it is not sat like Rajju, because there is Nivritti. And it is not asat like Vandhya Putra Ityadi. Why? Because of experience, anubhava. Therefore, there is a statement, you know, satchet na badhyeta, asatchet na pratiyeta. There is a sarpa pratiti, therefore it is not asat. There is sarpa badha, therefore it is not sativan. So, it is different from sat and asat. Kintu sadasad vilakshanaha anirvachaniyaha. Then what is this sarpa? What is the status of this sarpa? This sarpa is neither sat nor asat. Therefore, sat asat vilakshana. Sad vilakshanascha, asat vilakshanascha, esha sarpaha. Meaning anirvachaniha. That is anirvachaniya or mithya. Meaning which cannot be categorized as sat or asat. Why? Because of the reasoning given. Evam eva shuktyadhyadhikaraneshvapi aropita rajatadayaha tatkalikataya anirvachaniyataya utpannaha santaha pratibhanti. They are utpanna. ऑल दीज शुक्ति रजत इत्यादि शुक्त्यादि अधिकरणेषु शुक्त्याद्यधिकरणेष्वपि इवन इन दि भ्रांति स्थल भ्रम स्थल इन दि रजत सीन इन शुक्ति ऑल्सो दिस इज द अंडरस्टैंडिंग दिस शुड बी अंडरस्टूड एज आरोपित रजत इन दि शुक्ति आरोपित रजत एटसेट्रा विच एवर एग्जाम्पल यू टेक देर ऑल्सो सेम थिंग वॉट हैपन्स तात्कालिकतया इन दैट मोमेंट अनिर्वचनीय दैट विच कैनॉट बी कैटेगराइज एज सत और असत मीनिंग सदसद विलक्षण अनिर्वचनीयतया उत्पन्न संत अविद्या विक्षेप अविद्या कार्य टेक्स प्लेस देर दिस इज प्रोड्यूस बाय अविद्या विक्षेप एंड देन प्रतिभांति देर इज एन अनुभव ऑफ वॉट एवर शाइन्स फोर्थ देर अस्य अनिर्वचनीयस्य सर्पादेः ख्याति अनिर्वचनस्य ख्याति अनिर्वचन ख्याति षष्ठी तत्पुरुष वॉट इज अनिर्वचनीय सर्पादेः भ्रमस्थल वॉट एवर इज सीन इन भ्रमस्थल दो सर्प रजत इत्यादि देर ख्याति नॉलेज देर नोइंग देम कर्मणि षष्ठी देर सर्पादेः ख्याति प्रसिद्धिः ख्याति प्रसिद्धिः विच इज प्रतीति very well known because it appears and then there is an appearance of sarpa ityadi spuranam abhivadanancha anirvachaniya khyatir ityuchyate so everything else is similar so that is the definition of anirvachana khyati brahmasthale sarpajnanam api avidya parinamah sarpata jnanayor yugapad deva utpatti layau sarpah sakshi bhasyascha Now this sarpa is seen, but it is not an antakkarana modification. What is it? It is avidya vritti. Brahmasthale. Earlier we have refuted every khyati, including the akhyati, where the sarpa smriti is there. Smriti rupa jnana, and there is a idamamsha. Jnana through Rajju, which is in the front of the person. Where there is Pratyaksha. Pratyaksha Jnana, Anubhava Jnana of Idamamsha of Rajju. And there is a Smriti Jnana of Sarpa. There we had question, how can you have a disconnect between Artha and Jnana? You cannot have a disconnect between Artha and Jnana. Artha is Rajju. Jnana is of Sarpa. But Niyadhina Jnana. Nyadhinam jnanam. How can you have a disconnect? In our case, there is no disconnect. Why? Because Brahmasthale sarpajnanam api avidya parinamaha. Sarpajnana, not only the sarpa is vikshepa of avidya, which is adishthana, rajju, adishthana, which is rajju, rajjavachinna, चैतन्य निष्ठ अविद्या परिणाम और विक्षेप एंड ज्ञान विच टेक्स प्लेस इन दी अंतकरण सर्प ज्ञानम अपि अविद्या परिणाम ज्ञान इज इन कीपिंग विद दी सर्प ज्ञान इज इन कीपिंग विद दी सर्प अर्थ विच इज दी मॉडिफिकेशन ऑफ अविद्या आउटसाइड सो देर इज नो डिस्कनेक्ट बिटवीन प्रत्यक्ष अनुभव of sarpa outside and the jnana which is inside. So that is also avidya parinama. Within also there is a avidya parinama, without also, outside also there is an avidya parinama. Sarpa tajnana yor, sarpa and tajnana. There is sarpa outside and sarpa jnana within. Yugapa deva utpatti layav. They are born simultaneously and when there is badha, they are badita simultaneously. Sarpa sakshi bhasyascha. But sarpa is seen by sakshi. Just like sukha dukkha anubhava, we had seen there. Sukha dukkha vritti are sakshi bhasya. Similarly, sarpa pratibhasika is all sakshi bhasya. Yatha sarpadihi avidya parinamaha, tatha tatrusha sarpadi jnana rupa vritti api avidya parinama eva. Just like sarpa outside is avidya parinama, similarly sarpa within, sarpa jnana within is also avidya parinama. It is sarpadi jnana roopa vritti, because every unit of knowledge is through vritti. That vritti is also in keeping with the sarpa outside. Sarpa tadrusha sarpadi jnana roopa vritti api vrittirapi avidya parinama eva natu antakkarana parinama. Antakkarana does not modify, but there is the chaitanya which is all pervasive. The artha, sarpa as artha, padartha, is an avidya vikshepa of the avidya which is Rajju Nishtha. I'll just say Rajju Chaitanya Nishtha there. There's a long compound, but we'll just simplify it and say Rajju Avachinna Chaitanya. And there is Antakkarana Avachinna Chaitanya. Antakkarana of the person who is cognizing, who is Bhramita. There is Chaitanya pervading through and through, but they are limited by the Antakkarana, this person who is this Jiva now. And there is a Padartha outside, Rajju really, but seen as Sarpa. So Sarpa is projected there by the avidya transformation which is present in the Rajju. Whereas the Chaitanya which is segmented by the Antakkarana also undergoes change simultaneously by becoming Rajju Jnana, Jnana Vritti in the Antakkarana. So, natu antakkarana parinama, ata eva adhisthana rajjvadi sakshat karana aropita sarpadihi eva aropita sarpadi jnanam api badhyate. Therefore, badha is also simultaneous. They come up together, but since the parinama of sarpa and sarpajnana both, sarpatajnana, sarpatajnana yoho, parinamaha is all simultaneous yugapat. Both are simultaneous. Therefore, when one is badhita, the other will also become badhita. Ata eva adhisthana rajjvadi sakshat karana. Once you know Rajju as Rajju, then the sadasad vilakshana anirvachaniya sarpa which is born outside, which is there, but not really there. Real for anubhava, but unreal for transaction, because badhita. Sat is what? Trikala badhita sat. It is not trikala badhita sat. It will be negated in time. It was not there before the sarpanubhavaha, sarpabhranti. It will go away after the Rajju is known as Rajju. Therefore, it is going to undergo badha. It will be negated. Therefore, it is not sat. So that kind of a sadvilakshana sarpa is there. Is it asat? It is not asat. Why? Because there is anubhava. The fear is real for the person. He is seeing sarpa. Therefore, it is not asat either. So it is asat vilakshana. Being sadvilakshana and asat vilakshana, it is anirvachaniya. That anirvachaniya sarpa, which is avidya parinama, causes the sarpa jnana to take place in the antakkarana through the transformation of avidya, which is antakkarana gata chaitanya or antakkarana avachinna chaitanya, nishta avidya. That avidya undergoes change, and then simultaneously sarpa as well as sarpa jnana are born. When the Rajju is known, since the sarpa outside is not real, once you know the Rajju, then Rajju Jnanena Sarpa Nivrittihi. Similarly, in the Antakkarana also, simultaneously, the Avidya is negated by the Rajju Jnana, Adhisthana Jnana, then the Aropita Sarpa will go away. Sarpa Jnana will go away, which is Bhranti really. It is not Pramarupa Jnana, it is Brahmarupa Jnana. That Brahmarupa Jnana will also go simultaneously. Sarpa Jnana goes away in sync with the badha of the sarpa outside. Both are together. So they come up together, they go together. Tasya, so ataha eva adhisthana rajjvadi sakshat karana aropita sarpadir eva aropita sarpadi jnanam api badhyate. Even that sarpa jnana is negated like the aropita sarpa outside. Tasya antakkarana parinamatve to na badho yujyate. If the sarpa within, seen within, is antakkarana parinama, then it will not go, because avidya modifying and avidya being negated won't take away the antakkarana modification. Antakkarana parinat tasya antakkarana parinamatve tu na badho yujyate. Ataha aropita sarpadivat tajnanam api avidya karyatvat sarasadvilakshanam anirvachaniyam bhavati. So the aropita sarpa is also like aropita sarpa, aropita sarpadivat, vating pratyaya has been used. Like the aropita sarpa, similarly tajnana aropita sarpa sarpadivat, we'll leave the adi right now, aropita sarpavat aropita sarpajnanamapi. So sarpa as well as sarpajnana also is avidya karya, and being avidya karya, avidya karyatvat sarasad vilakshanam anirvachaniyam bhavati. You cannot categorize it as sat or asat. It is anirvachaniya, different from sat and asat. Apitu ayam vishesha. What is the difference between the two though? Pratibhasika sarpadi rajvadyupahita adishthana chaitanyastha tamoguna pradhana avidyamsha parinamaha. A long compound. But at least, you know, it is not navyanyaya. Navyanyaya would be very difficult to understand with such long compounds. Here the compounding is not that difficult. Pratibhasika sarpadi. The pratibhasika sarpa. Sarpa is not real. It is utpanna but not satkarya. It is avidya karya. Pratibhasika sarpadihi rajvadhi upahita adishthana chaitanya. This much we know. If the chaitanya is the adishthana, which is upahita in the rajju. You see, rajju also has chaitanya. Therefore, the chaitanya which is one without a second is kind of identified with rajju there. We say it is there in the rajju. Only that area we consider. That rajjvadyupahita adishthana chaitanyastha. In that chaitanya, there is avidya. Now, this avidya is maya. There is no difference between avidya and maya. At the individual level, we use the term avidya. At the universal level, we call it as maya. Both are interchangeable. In ekajivavada, we'll say maya and avidya are same. Exactly same. Because there is no other jiva. You cannot have a second avidya. In fact, in vivarana, there is no second avidya at all. Avidya is only one. There is no one. Jivanishta avidya. Avidya is really brahmanishta. Anyway, that's an aside. But maya, we already know that it is trigunatmika maya. Sattva, rajas, tamas, all three gunas are there. So which guna undergoes change here? Tamo guna. Tamo guna pradhana. There is also there definitely, but tamo guna is pradhana. That avidya which has tamo guna pradhana, that kind of aumsha, tamo guna pradhana avidya aumsha parinamaha. The sarpa outside, pratibhasika sarpadihi rajvadyupahita adishthana chaitanyastha tamoguna pradhana vidyamsha parinamaha. Outside, it is a tamoguna parinama. We'll just keep it very short and say what is the idea there. The chaitanya is an adishthana delimited by rajju ityadi. That kind of chaitanya, meaning rajju, in the rajju, the chaitanya that is there, that is an adishthana for avidya. That avidya we have seen transforms into sarpa, which is pratibhasika sarpa. There, it is modification of which guna pradhana. In the avidya, what is pradhana there? Tamo guna is pradhana. This is the padartha outside. Tadvishayaka vritti jnanantu. The vritti jnana, avidya vritti jnana, which is within. What about that? Tadvishaya is pratibhasika sarpadi vishaya. Vishayaka. Kapratya indicates a bahuri. So vritti, which has its vishaya, which is pratibhasika sarpadi. So pratibhasika sarpadi vishayaha. Pratibhasika sarpadihi vishayaha yasyaha vrittehe sa vritti. Pratibhasika sarpadi vishayaka vritti. That vritti, vritti is jnana. So tadvishayaka vritti is pratibhasika sarpadi vishayaka vritti jnanam tu, which is within. इदमाकार वृत्ति अभिव्यंजक साक्षी चैतन्यस्थ सत्व गुण प्रधान अविद्यांश परिणाम इति विवेक डिफरेंस हियर दो दि पदार्थ आउटसाइड सर्प विच इज प्रातिभासिक दैट इज अ मॉडिफिकेशन ऑफ अविद्यांश विच इज तमोगुण प्रधान प्राधान्येन तमोगुण वेर एज दि विक्षेप विद इन इज ऑल्सो ऑफ अविद्या बट इट इज सत्व गुण प्रधान सो हियर यू सी रज्ज्वाद्युपहित अधिष्ठान चैतन्यस्य तमोगुण प्रधान अविद्यांश परिणाम इज प्रातिभाषिक सर्पादि दिस पदार्थ आउटसाइड तद्विषयक वृत्ति ज्ञानं तु द वृत्ति ज्ञान विच इज विद इन सर्प वृत्ति विच इज सर्प ज्ञान वृत्ति रूप ज्ञान सर्प ज्ञान विद इन इज इदमाकार इदमाकार वृत्त्यभिव्यंजक So, idamakara is Rajju's part, idamakara. That has already taken place. When that vritti takes place, idamakara vritti, where Rajjuakara is missing, visheshamsha is missing, then idamakara vritti abhivyanjaka, that idamakara vritti will manifest chaitanya, which is sakshi chaitanya. So, idamakara vritti abhivyanjaka sakshi chaitanyastha. In that sakshi chaitanya, in that innocence, resting upon that as a substratum sakshi chaitanya exists in which on which there is avidya resting that avidya also has three gunas trigunatmika maya avidya there sattva guna pradhanyena avidya amsha parinamah bhavati what is that parinama is vritti roopa jnana sarpa vritti jnana so in simple words the padartha outside and jnana within they are both are the vikshepa karya of avidya but outside there is a tamoguna pradhana avidya which is the karana for vikshepa whereas within where there is sarpa jnana that is vikshepa of sattva pradhana avidya both are chaitanya nishtha one is sakshi chaitanya nishtha which is manifest due to idamakara within that jnana whereas outside it is rajju adyupahita adishthana chaitanyastha chaitanya nishtha anyway that is a difference it's too technical there whatever you get that's sufficient rajju adyupahita chaitanyastha avidya yada sarpadyakarana parinamate tada eva tadvrutyupahita sakshi chaitanyastha api avidya sarpadi jnana karana parinamate this is important simultaneously as and when the rajvadyupahita chaitanya which has avidya chaitanyastha or chaitanya nishtha avidya that avidya which is there resting upon the chaitanya everywhere when it modifies at the level of the rajju when rajju is not seen as rajju that time what happens the idamamsha is there which is seen Whereas the visheshamsha is what? The avidya in the Rajju Upahita Chaitanya, that avidya, it's specifically Tamoguna Pradhana avidya, modifies itself into Sarpa. And at that time, Yada Sarpa Adhyakarana Parinamate, that very moment, Tada Eva Tadvritti Upahita Sakshi Chaitanya Stha Api Avidya. Then, the idamamsha where rajju has shown the idamamsha idamakara vritti has taken place in that vritti that vritti which manifests the chaitanya tadvritti upahita sakshi chaitanya that sakshi chaitanya it also has avidya it also is the substratum for avidya that chaitanyastha api avidya sarpadi jnana karana parinamate but it is the sattva guna pradhana avidya so you have sarpa padartha outside which is also anirvachaniya and sarpadi jnana within which is also anirvachaniya simultaneously born yena karane rajvadyupahita chaitanyastha avidyayam kshobho jayate tenaiva karanena sakshi chaitanyastha avidyayam api kshobho jayate kshobha shobha is mentioned here as upadanasya karyabhimukhatvam kshobha So upadana, upa material cause, the material cause which karyabhimukhatvam, becoming a karya, projecting vikshepa here, that itself is called as kshobha. So here, the avidya is the upadana. And upadana avidya becoming karyabhimukha, showing up something, that is called a shobha. So when this yena karana rajvadyupahita chaitanyastha avidyayam shobho jayate, tenaiva karana sakshi chaitanyastha avidyayapi shobho jayate. The cause being same, they are simultaneously projected. The sarpa as well as sarpa jnana come up simultaneously because the cause for both of them is same. The reason is same, which is ajnana basically. Anyway, there was a tippana. I hope we didn't leave any tippana last time. We have seen the last tippana. Here there is a tippana. We'll look at that and then move on. Nanu sadvilakshanam asat. Now sadasad vilakshanam anirvachaniyam. That is in the mula. Sadar, what is this sarpa? It is vikshepa and it is neither sat nor asat. So there is an objection to this. If you have said it is not sat, then it means asat. If you say not asat, it means sat. So nanu sad vilakshanam asat. What is asat? Asat is that which is different from sat. Ataha sad vilakshanasya anirvachaniya anirvachaniya. I don't see what this letter is. Is it clear in your book, Venkatesh ji? This letter is not clear anyway. Nanu ataha
sounds like, yeah.
1 minute. Anirvachaniyasya. It is here. Okay. So then if asat is different from sat, then ataha sadvilakshanasya anirvachaniyasya. This anirvachaniya, which you are saying it is sadvilakshana. You are given a definition. So the Puropakshi is asking sadvilakshana, which is anirvachaniya. Sadvilakshanasya anirvachaniyasya asadvilakshanatva uktihi virudhyate. If you say it is sadvilakshana, no, it is sya. It is definitely sya, Venkateshi.
Yes.
So this sadvilakshanasya anirvachaniyasya, they are in samanadikaranu. So this anirvachaniya, which is sadvilakshana. You already said that sadvilakshana, then you make a compound asadvilakshana also. But before making the compound, hold on, says the Purvapakshi. As soon as you said that anirvachaniya is sadvilakshana, if you say sadvilakshana, then you have landed on asat. Then you cannot say asadvilakshana. Then sadvilakshanasya anirvachanasya asadvilakshanatva ukti. Saying that it is asadvilakshana also virudhyate. It is opposed. Why? Sadvilakshana is asat. Then you cannot say asadvilakshana. Tatha asataha vilakshanam sadeva. Similarly, if you take the opposite to that, if you say it is asatvilakshana. Asatvilakshana means sat. Then you cannot simultaneously in the same breath, you cannot say it is sadvilakshana also. अतः असतः विलक्षणस्य अनिर्वचनीयस्य सद्विलक्षणत्वोक्तिरपि असंगतः. That is also विरुद्धाय. If you say सद्विलक्षण, you have to accept असत. If you say असत विलक्षण, you have to say सत. You cannot say both simultaneously. तस्मात् सदसद विलक्षण तृतीय पदार्थस्य एव अभावा. There is nothing like sadvilakshana as well as asatvilakshana. Either it is sadvilakshana or asatvilakshana. If you say it is sadvilakshana, it is asat. If you say asatvilakshana, it is sat. There is no category called as sadasadvilakshana. Tasmat sadasadvilakshana tritiya padarthasya eva bhava. There is no other padartha called sadvilakshana as well as asatvilakshana. Therefore, anirvachaniya padat shabda bodha eva na udeshyati iti chet. Then shabda bodha will not take place. He says shabda bodha, which is vakya bodha. Sentence has to be understood in mimamsa. It is a textual analysis. When I hear the mantra, that time some shabda bodha has to take place for meaning to be understood. When somebody makes a statement, how do I understand? Because I understand the work, I understand the karakas, I understand the non-karakas, I understand the anvaya, then there is shabda bodha. Here you say sadvilakshana, then in my mind he says there is asat. If you say asadvilakshana, in my mind there is sat. There is no other category called sadasadvilakshana, so shabda bodha is not taking place. What kind of statement is this? इट इज अ मीनिंगलेस स्टेटमेंट सेज द पूर्वपक्षी इति चेत् न त्रिकाल अबाध्यत्वस्य एव सत्वात् इट इज नॉट अ वैलिड आर्ग्यूमेंट सेज द सिद्धांति बिकॉज व्हाट इज सत् ही सेज यू गो बैक टू द फाउंडेशन वी हैव सेड देयर इज समथिंग कॉल्ड अ सत् वी हैव डिफाइंड सत् व्हाट इज दैट सत् द सत् इज त्रिकाल अबाध्य which does not go away in all three periods of time, that is sat. But here sarpa will go away when rajju jnana takes place. In future it will go away. In fact it wasn't there earlier also, but at least in lat lakara it will go away. In future tense it will go away. Tad vilakshanam iti asya kalatrayapi badhyam ityartha siddhyati. Then if you take tad vilakshana, the Purvapakshi arguing that Sadvilakshana is Asat, then what is the meaning of Asat there? Asat meaning, even if the Purvapakshi takes Asat, the meaning would be Tadvilakshana. Asat will mean Kalatre Api Badhyam, that which will go away in at least one of the three periods of time, that will be the meaning of Asat. So Sat is what? Which will never go away. Asat is that which will go away one time or the other. That is Asat. This is not Asat. As in, it is Sadvilakshana, but it is Asat in a sense, Kalatraya Badhya it is, right. That is the Asat meaning. Then it is acceptable what Purvapakshi says. What we are saying is that Kalatraya Abhadhya it isn't. It is not Sat. That is what we mean by not Sat. निस्वरूप वंद्यापुत्रादि असद इत्युच्यते. एंड इफ यू टेक द अदर साइड, फ्लिप साइड, यू लुक एट व्हाट इज असत. असत इज नॉट डिफाइंड एज समथिंग विच इज निगेटेबल इन वन और मोर पीरियड्स ऑफ टाइम. इट इज दैट विच इज नेवर एक्सपीरियंस्ड. निस्वरूप, इट इज नॉट सस्वरूप एंड देन बाधित, बट निस्वरूप वंद्यापुत्रादि विच इज स्वरूपता एव नॉन एक्सिस्टेंट. दैट इज असत रियली. So Sadvilakshanam is not Asat. Purvapakshi is wrong when he says Sadvilakshana is Asat. Definitions of Sat and Asat should be taken the way we take it. Because it is Anirvachanyam is our definition. You cannot use somebody else's definition and come and call. You know, you use some other explanation of Nanj which is there in A, this Asat. You cannot use that. You have to use the Asat the way we have explained, the Sat we have explained, and then Sadasad Vilakshana the way we have explained. You cannot hold on to your misunderstanding and do an aropa on our tattva. This is true in all cases. When we go and fight with Tarkikas, we do not take our definitions and go and fight with them. When we argue with Tarkikas, we take their definitions and the battle is on their ground. You cannot have our own definitions and their definitions are different and you argue. This is what Dvaitis do. Dvaitis hold on to their own misunderstandings. They superimpose ideas on Advaita and then they come and fight. They say, you should have said this. In fact, there is one Vidvat Sabha where I saw with Brahmashri Manidravid Shastri ji. He was the only Advaitin and then they were doing an aropa on Advaita Siddhi, one statement where they say Bhagavan Madhusudana Saraswati should have said like this. Why? Because they say this is what it means. They're misunderstanding. The entire Sabha is on that. Then finally, Shastri said, what are you saying? Are you creating the text? You are not creating the text. You have to follow the text as per our definitions. You are analyzing the Advaita Siddhi, which is Advaita Siddhanta. You cannot use your own definitions. Similarly, here our definition for Sat is Trikala Badhita Sat. This Trikala Badhita Sat. Badhita Sat cannot be countered by saying Asat is Sadvilakshana, and that Asat definition you hold on to. Asat is not Sadvilakshana only. Asat is which is Niswarupa. So Niswarupa Vandyaputradi Asad ityuchyate. Tataha Vilakshanam ityasya Swarupavat ityartaha. Then when you say Sat, the way you have misunderstood, O Purvapakshi, you have misunderstood Asat Vilakshana Sat, but it is not Sat. Asat Vilakshana is what? Swarupavan. Swarupavan ityartha. Niswarupa Vilakshana is Swarupavan. Vandyaputra does not have Swarupa, Niswarupa. something which has sarupa, anything that has sarupa is sat. It is not trikala badita sat, but it is the sat that you have taken is not our sat. So we are saying the sat and asat vilakshana is as per our definition of sat and asat, not your definition of sat and asat, which is just sat vilakshana and asat vilakshana. We are not saying sat vilakshana, asat vilakshana, vilakshana. We are saying sat vilakshana and asat vilakshana. Tataha vilakshana mityasya swarupavan, swarupavat in neuter, swarupavan in pullinga, swarupavati in strilinga, swarupavat ityartha matupanta. Tasmad bhajyatve sati. Swarupatvam anirvachaniya padasya artha. What is anirvachaniya? Bhajyatve sati swarupavatvam. This is the definition here. What we mean by anirvachaniya, if you do not understand, we will explain the tarkika language. What is this? Bhajyatve sati swarupavatvam. So this is how they define it. Badhyatve sati sarupatvam means it has swarupa, but that swarupa is what? Going to have badha. So that swarupa which undergoes badha, that swarupa means swarupavat, that which has swarupa, meaning it is not niswarupa like Vandhyaputra as swarupa, it will be anubhuta, there will be pratyaksha. Pratyaksha anubhava, there will be cognition of that, and that which can be cognized but undergoes badha, that is anirvachaniya. So anirvachaniya padasya artha kim, artha kaha badhyatve sati swarupottam. This is lakshana. Badhyatve sati swarupottam is the meaning, lakshana, definition of anirvachaniya. Sarasad vilakshana or badhyatve sati swarupottam. If sadasad bhyam anirvachaniya is misunderstood, you can use bhajyatve sati swarupavatvam. Tathacha rajju sarpadeeriva prapanchasya api anirvachaniyataya eva bhanam vedanta nipunam bhavati. Now the tippanakara has jumped the gun and says, you understand this example, you have understood the exemplified also. He says similarly, rajju sarpavat, this prapancha is rajju sarpavat. It is avidya karya, maya karya, it is a vikshepa, comes up simultaneously, meaning, see, this is drishti srishti vada, comes up simultaneously and is badita jnana simultaneously. The world outside comes up, as and when it comes up, there is jnana, or other way if you understand it, as and when there is jnanotpatti within, as avidya karya, sattva pradhana vidya karya, simultaneously there is tamo pradhana vidya karya outside, and both are simultaneous. They go simultaneously when Brahmad, which is the adhishthana for avidya maya, is known as Brahma, then there is avidya nivritti, thereby avidya karya nivritti. What kind of karya? The prapancha nivritti as well as prapancha jnana nivritti. This is the siddhanta. Vedanta nipunanam bhavati. Those who are experts in Vedanta, for them, this is the understanding. So he's already gone ahead and concluded. This is the tippana. Tasmad brahmasthale. In the mula, we'll just see where this, where we can take a pause there. Tasmad brahmasthale sarpadi. Sarpadi vishayaha. Tasmad brahmasthale sarpadi vishayaha tajnanani cha yugapadeva utpadyante. So in the Brahma pratibhasika satta, we see the padartha coming up simultaneously, yugapat, simultaneously with the jnana within of the vishaya. Vishaya and vishaya jnana come up together. Rajvadi adhishthana sakshat karana yugapadeva praliyante cha, and they go away together. Now in the mula, only the pratibhasika padarthas are being discussed. It is not applicable to Vyavaharika yet. It is an example. The example will be extended to the exemplified later. But in the Tippana, he has already extended. Itthancha brahmasthale bahya chaitanyastha avidyamsha sarpadi vishayopadana karanam bhavati. Then what happens? Itthancha brahmasthale, wherever there is pratibhasika stala, there bahya chaitanyastha avidyamsha. So he simplified it further. Bahya chaitanyastha avidyamsha. There is bahya chaitanya and antas chaitanya. This is a division based on upadis. then bahya chaitanyastha vidya chaitanya is adhishthana for avidya whether outside or inside therefore bahya chaitanyastha avidya ansha which is tamo ansha sarpadi vishaya upadana karanam bhavati it becomes the upadana karana that's the material cause it is the upadana karana for sarpadi vishaya outside vishaya padarthas antasakshi chaitanyasya avidyamsha the sakshi chaitanya within has avidya as well that avidya which is resting upon sakshi chaitanya within sattva pradhana there sarpadi vishayaka jnana roopa vrittyupadana karana bhavati it is the material cause for the sarpadi jnana so outside there is transformation of avidya of in the form of vishaya inside there is a vishaya jnana which is also transform of avidya swapne tu now what about swapna there also it is pratibhasika satta swapne tu antasakshyashraya avidya gata tamo gunaamsha vishaya karana parinamate you have talked about bahya and antas chaitanya but swapna does not have bahya and anta what about swapna so if the question is about swapna which is also pratibhasika satta there swapna in swapna to antasakshyashraya in the in within itself there is tamo guna also so antasakshyashraya avidya gata tamo guna ansha vishaya karena parinamate then the tamo guna of the avidya within itself which is sakshyashraya chaitanya sakshi is the ashraya sakshi is the sakshi chaitanya this to antakarana sakshyashraya avidyagata tamogunaamsha vishaya karana parinamate there the tamoguna of the avidya within transforms itself into the prapancha swapna prapancha tadrusha avidyagata sattva gunaamsha tajnana karana parinamate and then the swapna prapancha jnana is the tamo the sattva guna of the avidya within so in the case of the pratibhasika sarpa outside what happens is that there is tamo guna of the avidya transforming outside whereas in swapna the tamo guna of the avidya within is transforming as a vishaya then the sattva ansha transforming as jnana is common in the pratibhasika satta outside and in swapna also so the difference has been given that the tamo guna of the avidya outside changes in the waking state in the pratibhasika satta brahmasthala whereas the in swapna there is nothing outside therefore the tamo guna of the avidya itself changes as vishaya whereas sattva guna pradhana sattva guna ansha transforms itself into tajnana meaning swapna prapancha jnana ataeva swapne antastha avidya eva vishaya tajnanayo ubhaya upadana karanam bhavati therefore upadana karanam material cause for the विषय एंड विषय ज्ञान इन द केस ऑफ डे ड्रीमिंग आई विल जस्ट शिफ्ट दिस एंड से दैट डे ड्रीमिंग वर्सेस ड्रीमिंग डे ड्रीमिंग इन द सेंस नॉट आई शुडंट से डे ड्रीमिंग ओके आई विल स्किप दैट आई विल नॉट से दैट बिकॉज़ स्वप्न डे ड्रीमिंग इज आल्सो स्वप्न बट हियर प्रातिभासिक इन भ्रम वर्सेस स्वप्न आई विल से भ्रम वर्सेस इन भ्रम आउटसाइड देयर इज डिफरेंट मटेरियल कॉज फॉर द विषय एज वेल एज द as the vishaya jnana in the swapna the vishaya and vishaya jnana have the same upadana karana that is the difference there ataeva swapne antastha avidya eva vishaya tajnanayor ubhayor upadana karanam bhavati anena eva hetuna bahya raju sarpadayaha antara swapnika padarthascha sakshi bhasya ityuchyante therefore anena eva hetuna bahya raju sarpadaya antara स्वाप्निक पदार्थाश्च वेदर यू सी बाह्य सर्पय और यू सी स्वप्न विदिन स्वप्न पदार्थ विदिन बोथ आर साक्षी भाष्य ऑल पदार्थ आउटसाइड एंड इनसाइड आउटसाइड इन द भ्रमस्थल एज वेल एज इनसाइड इन द स्वप्न बोथ आर साक्षी भाष्य बिकॉज द ज्ञान इज is transformation of avidya within avidya vritti dwara yadyat sakshi prakashayati tat sakshi bhasyam ityuchyate so whatever is known through avidya vritti in the brahmasthala also ది జ్ఞాన ఇస్ త్రూ అవిద్యా వృత్తి నాట్ అంతఃకరణ వృత్తి అండ్ ఇన్ ది స్వప్న ఆల్సో దేర్ ఇస్ అవిద్యా వృత్తి దేర్ ఫోర్ వాట్ ఎవర్ ఈస్ అ మోడిఫికేషన్ ఆఫ్ అవిద్య అండ్ నోన్ త్రూ అవిద్యా వృత్తి అవిద్యా వృత్తి ద్వారా యద్యత్ సాక్షి ప్రకాశతీయతి తత్ సాక్షి భాష్యం ఇత్యుచ్యతే ఫైనలీ సాక్షి విల్ లైట్ అప్ ది వృత్తి అండ్ ఇన్ ది కేస్ ఆఫ్ అవిద్యా వృత్తి ఇన్ ది కేస్ ఆఫ్ భ్రమస్థల ఇన్ ది కేస్ ఆఫ్ సారీ భ్రమ అండ్ ఇన్ ది కేస్ ఆఫ్ స్వప్న ఆల్సో బోత్ ఆర్ అవిద్యా వృత్తి అండ్ దే ఆర్ లిట్ అప్ బై ది సాక్షి దేర్ ఫోర్ దే ఆర్ కాల్డ్ సాక్షి భాష్యం So that is the 147th avarta. We look at the 148th in the next quarter. Sukhan nityam saprakasham vyapakan namurupe adhishtanam buddhya bodhyam buddher ketti nirvana aparam sarvedanta vidyam pratyek paramah tadeva anvatya iti nishitamatihi. Any questions? I'll see you in the next part. Namaste.
Hari Om. Hari Om.